but a bed at 6 a.m. I mean exactly 6 a.m. From 6 a.m. to hop up to 6, bathe, shave, dress. Then down to breakfast, 6:31, and not 1 minute less. 3 minute pig, not 2 and a half, not 3 and a half, but 3. Life by the clock, that's me. A man you can set your watch by. 6:45, I'm out the door, not 46 or 44. Arrive at office 6:59 on the dot. And that's precisely 6:59, when am I ever not? Week after week, for year after year, not 1 minute late indeed. My epitaph might read, a man you can set your watch by.
Good morning, Mr. Strether. Nasty weather, Mr. Strether. Looks like winter's settled in to stay.
Good day, Mr. Strether.
I say, Mr. Strether, that's a most becoming shade of gray.
Down to my lunch, the stroke of 12. I said and mean the stroke of 12. From 1 p.m. to 5:55. Work, work, work. Then leave the office, 6 on the chime, the marvel of my clerk. Back to the house the long way round, the rest of my evening free. Happy and proud to be a man you can set your watch by.
Good evening, Mr. Strether. Wretched weather altogether. Spring's a little late this year.
How true.
Hello, Mr. Strether. Late snow, Mr. Strether. Why can't spring be right on time, like you?
Back at the house at 6:15, I mean exactly 6:15, from 6:15, an hour to relax, dress, drink, dine, then read the time till 8:45, digesting every line. Set the alarm, then fall off to sleep, as sound as your broker's rock.
Ah, there's Mrs. Strether's knock. A man you can set your clock by.
Assuming a man has to set his clock.
I've been giving myself reasons for my son's not returning home. Every conceivable reason. Except the one I couldn't bring myself to accept. Until today. I've just had a letter from Paris. Not as I'd hoped from my son. The letter's unsigned. The anonymous kind. I fear that the boy is undone. I'm worried about his not writing. 17 weeks to the day. This letter, I fear, makes it shockingly clear why he's been prolonging his stay. It's a woman, as I've secretly suspected all along.
Surely you know better than to credit such a letter.
It's a woman, no, a mother's intuition's never wrong.
Why, the little foxy went and got himself a doxy.
It gives no description whatever. Just an impression at best. It mentions no name. She's quite without shame. You'll see when I read you the rest. They're seen almost nightly together. In places no good woman goes. She keeps a retreat where they frequently meet.
To do what the Lord only knows.
It's a woman. It's a woman. It's some common little fortune-hunting wench.
Overdressed and painted with her hair and models tainted.
Really, mother, how could brother?
And to make it even worse, the woman's French.
Well, there's a chance she may be just a passing fancy.
It's been going on for some time now. It's more than a passing affair. A rumor is rife, she may soon be his wife.
Without your consent, would he dare?
It's a woman, it's a woman.
If I know the type, she's widowed or divorced.
Doubtless she'll be clever, buy her off, or do whatever.
It's a woman, it's a woman.
If she can't be bought, the creature must be forced.
If she's hard to handle, there can be an open scandal.
When a son doesn't write to his mother, the handwriting's there on the wall. And she knows all too well he has one foot in hell. And the cause of her son's downfall is a woman.
It's a woman.
It's a woman.
It's a woman.
It's a woman behind it all.
It's a woman.
Just rush off to Paris and return the prodigal son to his mother's waiting arms. I'd like to remind her that I am a lawyer, not a truant officer. Now, if she asked me to facilitate a real estate transaction, her satisfaction, I'd guarantee, leave it to me, fait accompli. Oh, Lambert, go and get a court injunction. Here I could function with lightning speed. I could indeed, and I'd succeed. If she said file a suit or settle a dispute, I wouldn't need a soul to show me how. But this sort of thing, even Blackstone couldn't help me now. What do I say to the boy, a boy I haven't seen in ages? Lecture him on the wages of sin. How do I cope with a lad who's heir to all he's heir to? Deuced if I know just where to begin. Do I make the strong suggestion or insist? The velvet glove could I unmail if the mademoiselle in question does exist? Can she be bought, and how do I make the sale? Say for the sake of the argument, she out and out refuses. What if it's war she chooses? She might. I'm not afraid in a court of law to face a hostile jury, but braving a woman's fury, I fight. I'm going in over my head, I know. I'm rather too easily led, I know. I'm damned if I know why I said I'd go. But then, I may never get the chance to see Paris again.
Chad, had said this was to be a small affair.
The boy was trying to flummox you, Lambert. Like all that balderdash about his not being in a woman's hands. You didn't believe that, did you?
Well, it certainly couldn't be any of these ladies. They're obviously quite refined.
Many an edible apple conceals a worm, Lambert.
Oh, come, Waymarsh.
Bon scotch, bon chocolat, c'est la bonne smile, le sang, c'est très sexy, let's go,
right clues,
jolie,
right wine, right booze,
stop,
right bike, and mistress,
right bike,
and mistress,
this is
right
the
glass,
right
stance,
for me,
right glass, the right advances,
charlotte,
bon, magique,
red
course,
to pay match,
your feet, right horse,
blondine,
name,
très chic,
red man,
gentil,
right game, right verse,
stop all the clocks,
right
at midnight,
put the right example
right here and now in Paris.
Every day is a gift, life ties with a bow. What a beautiful bow life ties. And I can't wait to see what my day will be. Surprise! Every day is an affair, a grand love affair. Life and I simply can't disguise. We may quarrel, but then when we meet again, surprise, have the fun of living from day to day, is not knowing what tomorrow will bring. One morning you rise, you open your eyes, and winter's surprise is spring. Every day is a friend, life wants me to meet, and when I'm with my friend, time flies. For I quite understand that my new friend has planned a great, big, beautiful surprise. When life holds its hands out and says which one, it will make no difference which hand I choose. The right hand, surprise, the left hand, surprise, I don't ever seem to lose. Every day is a song that has to be sung. Life and I love to all.
She's quite beyond me, but I think you'll agree that we've nothing to fear on that score. The lady could hardly be more charming, charming, charming. I'm not sure at all, is she walking or waltzing? She seems to be made out of air. One isn't quite sure that she's there. Charming, charming, charming. How artless her smile, so completely beguiling. How flawless her figure and face. How artful the mold of those elegant shoulders. A picture of womanly grace. The maddening way that she has of displaying. An ankle could drive one insane. her way with a glass of champagne. Brilliant, enchanting, disarming, and charming, charming, charming.
How formal he is with that habit of his, of inserting his hand in his vest. Pretending he isn't impressed. Charming, charming, charming. How awkward his tones as he tried not to glance at my ankle a moment ago. He pale, if he knew that, I know. Charming, charming, charming. He looks as distraught as a fish out of water. He couldn't be more ill at ease. If taught how to dress, he could be quite impressive. Imagine, champagne makes him sneeze. That air of malaise when he lowered his gaze as he tried to avoid meeting mine. He's feeling his one glass of wine. Darling, appealing, disarming, and charming, charming, charming.
My life, I've closed every door, missed every train, stayed close to the shore. All of my life, I've settled for less, turning my back on my happiness. All of my life, I've had to say no, no to my dream. Now where did it go? What did I get? And what did I give? All of my life, waiting to live, waiting to shake the tree until the fruit was dry, waiting to climb a hill until it grew too high, waiting to fall in love until it passed me by. Waiting, waiting. Am I too late by too many years? Too late for love and too late for tears. Waiting to take, not daring to give. Living my life, all of my life, all of my life.
Can you do?
Every painter worth his palette, every sculptor worth his mallet, wants to do a nude superior to the rest. Though artistically it pays to, it's not easy nowadays to, there are just so many ways to paint a breast.
What can you do? What can you do when your new face refuses to be pursued? What can you do?
When you strip her clothes away, she's a big cliche.
What can you do with a nude?
Mona Lisa, for example, though her charms were more than ample, didn't have to stoop to nudity to beguile.
Have it the lost the greater Madonna, if Da Vinci had the one, a painter wearing nothing on her but a smile.
Whistler solved the problem neatly by avoiding it completely. Think of every Whistler painting you ever saw. But he wasn't such a dummy. It's enough to turn your tummy when you think of Whistler's mummy in the raw.
What can you do? What can you do? As she looms assuming an attitude, what can you do?
Once you've finished with the crown, from the neck on down,
what can you do with a nude?
Should you paint her as a goddess with a satyr at her bodice, or a naiad that a satyr is lunging toward?
Or a virgin, for that matter, with a satyr leering at her?
I don't know about the satyr, but I'm bored.
Well, what can you do? What can you do? Pray to God some model will be tattooed. What can you do?
For the minute you're confined to a blank behind,
what can you do with a nude?
You could pose her eating cheese on a field of fleur-de-lis.
You could paint her wearing shoes
or an interesting brew.
Or reclining in the grass with a daisy.
Don't be crass.
Well, apart from being dangerous, so will do. What can you do? What can you do? What can you do about it? What can you do that's new? What can you do? What can you do about it?
What
can you do with a new?
Just a minute, Strether. Don't pretend you don't know what's the matter with you. Don't pretend you don't know what's the matter you do. You're not the lost and lonely man you were. But why do you tell yourself all this? Tell her. Maybe she'll only laugh, but tell her, tell her. Why tear yourself in half? Just tell her, tell her. Don't go on living in your private shell. Now let your life begin. Go on and tell her, tell her. Is it so hard to say you love her, love her? Don't put it off the way you do. Why don't you go ahead and tell her? Oh, that your heart has. said to you. Isn't it time to live your life as well? You're not that other man. Go on and tell her. Tell her. Is it so hard to say you love her? Love her. Don't put it off the way you do. Why don't you go ahead and tell her? Tell her all that your heart has said to
thank you. Lila, monsieur?
What? Oh, I seem to have lost my way.
But monsieur has passed this way many times.
How absent of me, of course.
Bonsoir.
Bonsoir. These on the streets I knew, what happened to Paris? I thought the same was blue, it's gray as the dawn. Where is the charm and glow? What happened to Paris? Where did my parents go? And why has it gone?
Dare she come here with her heart in her hand, expecting forgiveness in full on demand. Accuse me of having my head in the sand. Was a shame. The nerve of the woman to criticize me. What kind of a fool does she take me to be? To have me believe it is I more than she who's to blame. Throwing herself on the mercy of the court, knowing it's her only chance of winning. The woman far more sinned against than sinning. What a performance! The brave little smile, the suggestion of a tear. Every woman's trick in her collection. The timing of her exit line perfection. What a performance! Just think how pleased your Mrs. Newsome will be, wasn't it? What pleases Mrs. Newsome pleases me. Doesn't it? Doesn't it? Doesn't it? Isn't this what I wanted? Isn't this why I came? Have I only changed so much in order to remain the same? Damn her smile. Damn her charm. Damn the day that I met her. Damned if I can forget her. I have to regret. That's too much to forget. Am I wrong? Is she right? Should I ever forgive her? Could I ever forgive her? Once she taught me to live. That's too much to forgive. Once she taught me to live. That's too much to forgive.
Wine is big sparkling friends. That's what I need tonight. Somewhere new where the music never ends. That's what I need tonight. Pink champagne by the magnum till the room starts to swim in a rosy blur of shaded candlelight. Gay cafes, crowded places, music lights, happy faces. I don't care anywhere it's loud and bright. That's what I need tonight.
Sparkling music, sparkling friends.
That's what I need tonight.
Well, it's new and the music never ends.
That's what I need tonight.
Pink champagne by the magnum
till the room starts to swim in a rosy blur of shaded candlelight.
Cafe, as requested, music lights, as requested.
Your idea, yes, it's absolutely right. Just what I need tonight.
Alain Marie, you look ravishing, my dear.
That's what I need tonight.
Ma chérie, you're the only woman here.
That's what I need tonight.
Shall we dance?
Never meaning what they say, passed down from mademoiselle to mademoiselle. They can look you straight in the eyes and tell the most believable lies. But there's one way a gentleman can always tell, not by what the mademoiselle has said, but by what she's wearing on her head. You can tell a lady by her hat, those little telltale things that ladies wear. As they go from this chapeau to that, I know what kind of lady's under there. The feather's white, the lady's giving me fair warning. The only way I'm going to bed her is to wed. The hat is black, the lady tells me she's in mourning. Her hopes of snaring you, monsieur, are dead. Ah, now here's one and quite revealing too, a work of art expensively refined. Hiding nothing, your hat, madame, is you. Designing it so openly designed. And what a self-revealing hat madame is wearing. The most becoming hat a woman ever wears.
the perfect hat, not too discreet, yet not too daring. For ending or beginning love affairs, as a gentleman I cannot, of course, ask madame which. Now I ask you, regardez ce chapeau, I know exactly where this lady's at. I can tell monsieur the answer's no, and it's no use trying, unless the hat is lying. You can tell a lady by her hat.
You will have to excuse me, I'm not feeling well.
Oh, I sincerely hope I've not offended any of the lovely ladies here tonight. And if I have, I hope they will forgive me. That's a very forgiving hat, isn't it? And I hope, too, that all these beautiful ladies will stop and think twice the next time they go shopping for a new chapeau. Now that they know, we know.
Dear, dear Lambert, how compromised you look.
There's not the slightest reason why I should.
Perhaps that's not the word. Come, come, Lambert, you're quite the open book. Don't try to put me off, you never could. I won't deny that I'm surprised at your position. Your blind acceptance of, well, Paris, shall we say? There seems a lack of dedication to your mission. You see what I've accomplished in one day.
I do indeed, Amelia.
Now, now, Lambert, no need to look so lost. No damage has been done, we can't repair. Come, come, Lambert, it's hardly worth the cost. Now let's dwell no more on, simply close the door on this utterly ridiculous affair.
Forget him for hours on end. There'll be days, whole days, I won't have to pretend. There'll be days I'll be happy, beginning to end. But not, no, not tomorrow. There'll be days I can smile when I'll hear his name, when I'll wish him well and myself just the same, when I'll hear myself saying he wasn't to blame. But not, no, not tomorrow. There'll be days I'll hear laughter that sounds like his, and not feel empty when I see an affair for just what it is, and take the end in my stride. There'll be nights I'll be able to sleep again. There'll be nights of wine, other smiles, other men, and he'll just be a memory, a boy I knew when. There'll be days I'll hear laughter that sounds like his, and nothing empty inside, when I see what it is, and take the end in my stride. There'll be nights
I'll be able to sleep again. There'll be nights of wine, other smiles, other men, and he'll just be a memory, a boy I knew. But not tomorrow.
How big is the bribe to be a seat on the board? How high is the price for helping to splice the umbilical cord? How high is your highest bid? How much do I hear? The governor's chair, I want to be fair. Start bidding, my dear. Lambert Strether up for sale. Race Caucasian, gender male. No bad habits, stronger body, sound of mind. Can't you hear the auctioneer? To the lady in the rear. Sold and forever consigned. We'd live in a house, your kind of house, a charming neo-Gothic bungalow. Doubtless each and every room, bright and cheerful as a tomb. No, thank you, no. You'd pick out our friends, your kind of friends, to keep our social status quo. Overfed and undersexed, each one duller than the next. No, thank you. Thank you, no. Give up Paris for Woollett? Why? To go back to a life of being told when to say no, when to say yes, how I must live, how I must dress, what I must think, what I must read, and if I'm cut, how much to bleed, whom to avoid, whom to receive, what to reject, what to believe, when to stop work, when to resume, where we go, when with whom? I'd be goaded, I'd be pushed, I'd be vetoed, I'd be shushed, I'd be badgered till I had any fight. So as not to go berserk, I'd submerge myself in work, burn the candle all day long and half the night. And I'd struggle and aspire till I suddenly caught fire, made a fortune and retired at 55. So that when I passed away on my deathbed, I could say, I never lived a day I was alive. No, thank you. All of my life, I closed every door, missed every train, stayed close to the shore. All of my life, I settled for less, turning my back on my happiness. All of my life, I had to say no, no to my dream. Now where did it go? What did I get? And what did I give? All of my life, waiting to live, waiting to shake the tree until the fruit was dry, waiting to climb a hill until it grew too high, waiting to fall in love until it passed me by, waiting, waiting. I wasted years, but now I can say, my life is mine, I'll live in my way, daring to take.
Just can't stop. I love to blow them up, 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 to hear them pop. Red ones, green ones, yellow, pink, and blue. If you'd like to blow balloons with me, I'll let you pop one too. It's so much fun, fun, fun to break balloons and hear them pop. Here's a pin for me.
use it, so much fun to do. It's so much fun to break balloons. I don't ever want to stop, so don't be bashful, Tom, my dear. I'm only happy when I hear them going pop, pop, pop.
Wine, I don't care, I get drunk on the air, they spike it here. I like it here. I love it here. I love it here. I'm alive, I'm aglow, life is sweet, and there's so much of it here.
Love for me, say let's breathe the body.
I love it here. Waking up every day to an April souffle, delightful.
Every day a souffle.
When they light up the lights, I could soak up the nights by the nightful.
Every night a delight.
It's splendid here.
Yes, we say repete.
It's splendid here.
Ah, mais we agree.
You're so warm, you're so real. It's no wonder I feel befriended here.
Everywhere you're aware, people care.
Here.
Every year is a souvenir.
Things to see, things to do. Every day something new, beguiling. People smile in their sleep. They wake up and they keep right on smiling.
People smile, it's a smile.
I like it here.
Out from you, we like you.
I like it here.
It's the key to Paris.
It's a grand love affair. I'm as rich as I care to strike it here.
Richer off where you are.
The excitement, the pace, it's a wonderful place. And I like it here.
Now to say you will stay.
Taken all together, I like it here.
Everybody likes it here.
What a wonderful thing it is to be born a man. Every man in the whole wide world is a lucky cuss. The masculine sex is the sex there's no better than. Yes, all in all, I'm deucedly glad we're us. What makes a man happy? He's a man. One guess, ah yes, la femme. What makes him glow? What inflames him so he melts? What else, la femme? What makes a strong man weak in the knees, excites him and shatters his calm? Ask any man since the world began, la femme, la femme, la femme. I ask you, what makes old men come alive again? That's right, tonight, la femme. One day we're tense, and the next immensely gay. Cherche la femme. What makes a man who's single and sane get married with hardly a qualm? Why beach about? We'd be lost without la femme, la femme, la femme. Look at me, Billum. Who would have thought 8 weeks could have wrought so strange a change? La femme. Look how I dress, lavender no less, for encore, la La Femme. Who took a pompous, stuffy old bore? The world had done all but embalm. And made him see how sweet life could be. La Femme, La Femme, La Femme, La Femme, La Femme, La Femme.
Your principles are a luxury you can ill afford. Surely not at the price of risking all that could lie ahead for you and me.
And if I'm prepared to take that risk?
Dear, dear Lambert, remember who you are, or more precisely, what you hope to be.
That's not the question here.
Dear, dear Lambert, I've taken you too far for you to take this attitude with me.
This attitude?
You've always stopped to weigh each word you've ever uttered.
I trust I have.
You've never made a hasty judgment in your life.
Nor do I now.
You've always known on just which side your bread was buttered.
I don't know what you mean.
Whose monogram was on the butter knife.
I think that's hardly fair.
Fair, there, Lambert. How compromised you look. Is that the guise a future judge should wear?
You choose your weapons well.
Come, come, Lambert. It's time we close the book on this utterly ridiculous affair.
But you're forgetting there's a moral obligation.
And you're forgetting what you came to Paris for. My son has made a most surprising accusation that I prefer, for your sake, to ignore.
What would you have me say?
Now, now, Lambert, you needn't look so lost. No damage has been done we can't repair.
But when you meet Marie...
Oh, come, come, Lambert, she isn't worth the cost. Let us dwell no more on. Simply close the door on this utterly ridiculous affair.
But...
and desired, and young with her, pampered and admired, so young with her. That's how she makes me feel. I come alive with her, bursting at the seams, alive with her. All my fading dreams revive with her. Wonderfully bright and real, I see myself in her eyes, and I like the me that I see. I see myself her eyes, and every time she's near, the years just disappear. I'm gay with her, laughter fills my every day with her. All I want is just to stay with her, for when she's close to me, I'll ever be. Young with her, young with her, so young with her, that's how she makes me feel. I see myself in her eyes, and I like the me that I see. I see myself in her eyes, and every time she's near, the years just disappear. I'm gay with her, my every day with her. All I want is just to stay with her. For when she's close to me, I'm young with her, young as I'll ever. All of my life, I closed every door, missed every train, stayed close to the shore. All of my life, I settled for less. Turning my back on my happiness. All of my life, I had to say no, no to my dream. Now where did it go? What did I get? And what did I give? All of my life, waiting to live, waiting to shake the tree until the fruit was dry, waiting to climb a hill until it grew too high, waiting to fall in love until it passed me by, waiting, passed me by, waiting, waiting. Now it's too late, by too many years, too late for love, and too late for tears. Take the very jugger.